Natasha Richardson was pronounced dead, announced dead yesterday. She had some freak accident in Canada. She was on the beginner slopes. And she,
on the beginner slopes?
She was on the bunny slopes.
Oh, and no, that's even more disastrous.
This is such a disastrous story, and it's... I can't imagine what Liam Neeson is feeling right now. But she fell, she hit her head, and, you know, they called the ambulance. And she said, you know what, I'm feeling fine. She was walking around, everything was okay, right? She turned the ambulance back, okay? She's like, I don't need their help. A few hours later, her headache got worse. And she's like, I'm not feeling well, I need to go to the doctor right away.
Uh-huh.
They took her to the doctor, and a few hours later, she was brain dead.
Wow, what happened? What, internal bleeding?
Internal bleeding. A lot of times when people hit their head, they don't realize that even though they feel fine, they could have internal bleeding. They should be checked out by a doctor right away, regardless of how good they feel. So that's what happened in this case. There was internal bleeding. Within a few hours, she was brain dead. The only thing functioning at that point was her heart. And, you know, yesterday they decided, you know, there's nothing left to do. She's not going to recover. And she passed away.
Man, that is devastating. I did not know the details. Let me, I have a couple of conclusions from this. One, man, if I ever hit my head again, I'm going straight to the doctor. I'm not playing around with that stuff, okay? Mm-hmm. And internal bleeding, man, we had a friend of the family die from that. And it's a tough thing to, you know, like, obviously the doctors can spot it. In that case, the doctor spotted it. It was in Turkey. It was the worst kind of tragedy ever. And they went to go drink tea, and then he died while they were drinking tea. So, man, take this stuff seriously. I know it might seem like, oh, come on, I don't want to bother people, whatever. But you got any kind of issue where you're even in a little bit of doubt, bother people, all right?
Right.
Number two, man, skiing is getting to be like the second biggest killer of, you know, celebrities and rich people after small plane accidents.
Honestly, I don't think that there's anything worse in the world than snow. I don't. I hate the snow. I don't understand why people do it, but...
No, but a number of people have died now. It's beginning to scare me. I mean, I used to ski seriously, and I think, right. You know, double X, triple X. I'm a serious-ass skier. I'm not playing, okay?
It scares me
this,
to death.
This gut goes around a mogul quicker than you can imagine. But now I'm starting to get worried. I mean, there was one of the Kennedys. Like, this is like the third or fourth famous person to die from skiing.
Right.
I'm
she was on the bunny slopes, which really scares me, because, I mean... The bunny slopes, that's where the beginners are. That's where there shouldn't be any danger at all. I mean, that's where ten-year-olds would learn how to ski.
I know, but then that makes me think that it was such a freak thing that you can't put it on skiing. Because, you know, it's if you're going down a double X and then, you know, you go over a cliff or something, yeah, that's on skiing. Or you hit a tree, that's on skiing. It's on you, right? The skiing didn't cause it, but that's one of the dangers of skiing. But on a bunny slope, it's like you tripped and you hit your head wrong. Right. You know, it could happen to anybody at any point. A bunny slope is like nothing. It's almost flat.
And,
so,
you know, you've talked about this so many times before, but she passed away at the age of 45, and you just don't know when you're going to go and how you're going to go. It just really makes you appreciate life more. It's so scary to think that, you know, at 45, you can have a freak skiing accident on a bunny slope somewhere in Canada. I don't know.
No, I know. So that's why I spent all of today preparing for this show. I feel like I really got the most out of my life.
Right.
It does make me wonder sometimes. Man, I better make it before. At least let me get the satisfaction of getting rich or something. Like taking some sort of retention bonus off of somebody's ass. Okay, before I go, let me get that little bit of pleasure. Because, man, if we're just going to keep going like this and at 70, be like, what did I do? What did I do?
No, but
I mean, I have fun.
Yeah, exactly.
I have fun.
You enjoy your job.
But we work hard, man. Like, all day today, I've been thinking, I got up at 6:30 because I passed out at night, to get everything ready. And all day, I've been thinking about Miami. Like, I got to go down to Miami. I got to go back. Because when we went this time, it was to get married, but all we did was, like, get things ready.
Right.
So I didn't have a chance to relax at all.
You guys should have spent a little more time there, like, afterwards.
No, I had to get back to work. We had to do some YouTube clips.